It's hard to believe, my friends, but it's true, it's real. What am I talking about? Well, I'm gonna start from the top. First and foremost, do you guys remember this PS3 game that is becoming a hit, The Last of Us, and apparently a bigger hit than the God of War series itself? Yes, for those who remember, good on you. For those who don't, let me just try to summarize the story. In the year 2003, the whole world is ravaged by zombies. Yeah, it's a zombie apocalypse. But what is peculiar about this zombie apocalypse is that the cause of this disaster is not a man-made virus or biological weapon or some kind of curse, some kind of mystical book or whatever. No, this is provoked by natural causes. Literally, nature is the one that is provoking this to humankind. Because the zombies are being created by some kind of a parasitic fungus, which aside from killing the host, what it does is this goes directly into the brain, it infects it, and then it takes over every single part of the body of the infected person. And in the physical part, I mean outside, it provokes malformations beyond repair, turning the infected into monsters. I think that it's very interesting to notice this because I don't really think that any single book of apocalypse, of zombie apocalypse, has done this kind of natural causes. This is, well, except for The Happening, but this one is a little bit more complex. And it's very similar to what happened in Dead Space. The only difference is that happens on Earth. But if I talk about the game, which is really good, I'm not gonna see anything new. So I'm just gonna focus in the cause of the zombies. Yes, the fungus. Let me tell you, my friends, something. This fungus is real. This fungus does exist, and right now it's provoking to some species the same thing that in the video game the infected are suffering. I'm not kidding. Okay, now let's start from the top. This kind of fungus has a particular name, and it's called Cordyceps. It's very simple. It comes from the Latin, which is cord, which means club, and set, which is gonna be head. So in other words, of course, a club head. Yeah, you can tell because of the figure that you can see in the hand as soon as the fungus is inside. Anyway, this little species was discovered in 1849 by the British biologist Alfred Russet Wallace. Well, what happened is that we're gonna see this kind of fungi everywhere, even in Australia. And in some cases, what will happen is that you're gonna see some small spores in all the soil near a hive of ants. Once in a while, a little ant was gonna do is to eat the grass, and all of a sudden meet with some of these spores, which through an enzymistic activity, an enzyme for being more simple, is gonna perforate through the skin of the ant until it slowly reaches every single vital organs, provoking these to just get destroyed and going to the muscles, which gonna suffer a serious atrophy. The only part that's gonna remain intact of the host is gonna be the brain. Now, after this process, this interesting process take place, what will happen is that the ant is gonna go this way, or how do you say this? Go astray of the rest of the colony, and will just eventually jungle to the top of a leaf, and with what is remains left of its mouth, it's gonna beat the vein of the leaf that the ant chose, remaining there for days. During this period of time, you're gonna appreciate that in the top of the head. Oh, by the way, before I go any further, by this time the ant is gonna be dead, and what's gonna control the movements of the little host is gonna be the myelin, a little black substance that comes with the spore. Now, as soon as the ant is dead, what's gonna happen is that the fungus is gonna provoke to grow this little club-like thing behind the head, and this could take days or months, the time that is necessary. But as soon as this fungi reaches maturity, it's gonna burst, and it will go into the ground, provoking that the spores made into the floor, and like the song says, the cycle starts again. Now this not gonna like no the ant will not attack so aggressively the other ants like in The Last of Us, but it will eventually go to the like reach the destruction of the hive itself. Now I saw something interesting in Animal Planet that says that as soon as the ant is on the top of the leaf, what's gonna happen is that any single predator, we're gonna eat this ant. And like for example, maybe a rabbit or any insectivorous animal. And even though this animal will not affect the, will not be affected by the sponge, as soon as the feces go into the ground, the sponge, like the spores, we're gonna spread again. And every single insect that goes nearby, a beetle, a fly, whatever, gonna suffer the same process. So the sponge itself would leave and gonna cause destruction to everyone near around the colony. Now, based on this explanation, this little fungi has nothing to envy to the T-virus in the Resident Evil, the Adam in Bioshock, the salts in Bioshock Infinite, or any biological weapon that you guys can imagine. Okay, this kind of fungi, the one that infects the creatures, can affect any species, not just ants. And it has this particular name, which is called Ophiocordyceps unilateralis. Now, I have bad news and good news for you. The bad news is that you have to hear this explanation. Imagine something little peculiar, some kind of man-eating virus that is not not eating your skin, but eating you inside out, destroying every one of your organs: the kidneys, the bladder, the lungs, the intestines, the lungs. And not only is killing you, it's just making you burn, feeling your heat, and destroying your body, making you feel bad, like some kind of a silkworm ready to get a little buffet of your body until it reaches your brain, until you have a severe headache and a severe heat in your head that eventually will kill you. Just imagine that. Yep, that's pretty much the sensation that all the victims in The Last of Us might be feeling before turning zombies. But the good news is, it's very unlikely that the cordyceps affects the human body anytime soon. And for a very good reason. The immunological system, which is stronger than the one that has the ants. And it can get rid of every single trace of the fungi that is in the human body. In fact, there is an interesting trivia. The cordyceps is also used for medical purposes in humans. How? I'm not quite sure, but I will assume it's for antibiotics or maybe for some kind of medicine. Maybe facing the yellow fever or maybe infections. Not quite sure. Yeah, I know my friends that this might not be relevant for you in the future, but I want to share it with you because I believe it's quite fascinating. And yes, regarding your question of maybe this not gonna affect us in the future, like this kind of cordyceps is not gonna affect humans in the future, or any variants is gonna affect us in the future, I would like to say no. But unfortunately, here is a real fact. The world is incredibly big. The nature is too complex. Do you guys remember the news in which recently a little rotten with this kind of big like limb in the face, this kind of trunk was discovered? And this little rotten has a sibling, like some kind of parentage with the elephants. On the other hand, we have a phenomenon like what happened to Joseph Merrick, the elephant man. Or even the Erwan Mandraki, famous for having a second face on his head. Now, the point what I'm trying to go with this is that, yes, maybe right now the cordyceps is not going to affect humankind. But
But what tells us that it's gonna remain like that in the future? I mean, what makes you think that a mutant strain of Cordyceps is not gonna destroy us? Think about it, because it might happen. Who really tells us that it will not? We have to give credit for the video game because it's based on reality, so it makes us think about this issue even more. I am Janitos, and I hope that you enjoyed this video as much, and the video game, of course, as much as I enjoyed to make it. Thank you very much. See you next time.